Hello, I'm Tristan, and this is the Hub2 from SwitchBot. It's kind of a big deal because this starts to bring matter support throughout all of SwitchBot's product lineup. And that's great because previously, if a smart home company wanted to support Amazon Echo, Google Nest, Apple HomeKit, and other platforms, they would need to go out and code up specific support for each separate platform, which takes a lot of time and money and often resulted in HomeKit simply being skipped over. But now companies just need to make a hub that is Matter certified and poof, wide-ranging third-party support magically appears. Well, not quite, but that's the general idea. Indeed, previously the SwitchBot Curtain did not natively support HomeKit, but due to the Hub 2 and its Matter support, this now does support Apple Home. And that's pretty cool. It's cool for SwitchBot because they can gain more customers, but it's also an awesome demonstration of the Matter project and why it's just so important for the smart home community. The Hub 2 is a nice upgrade over the previous Hub Mini, and it also keeps many of the same features from the discontinued Hub Plus. This has daylight, temperature, and humidity sensors, and thanks to Matter, this data will also pull through to the Apple Home app. All this data is displayed in the SwitchBot app, and it can be viewed back over different time periods, which is quite neat. Plus, you can export the data to a CSV if you'd like. You can also create home automations, or scenes, as SwitchBot calls them, based on these values. For example, you could say that when it gets dark enough, your curtains should automatically close. Or you could say that if it gets too humid in a room, turn on a dehumidifier, either by using the SwitchBot bot or a SwitchBot smart plug. It's surprising just how powerful all this can be. With just the Hub 2 and a few of SwitchBot's products, you can create a genuinely powerful smart home with ease. The Hub 2 looks fairly sleek, with an LED backlight that clearly displays the temperature and the humidity. The Hub 2 is powered with USB-C, and it has a prop arm on the back, so you can easily stand on a desk or a shelf when it goes through there. It also comes with M3 adhesive strips if you wanted to wall mount it. It has two on-screen buttons which default to turn in the screen on and off, but you can customize this to trigger scenes via the app. So in this case, I've set the on button to open my curtains, and then the off button will close them again. But naturally, you can configure this how you'd like, and you can also chain multiple actions together in the app. You could also specify that your SwitchBot cameras could stop recording when you click off, or you could turn on various devices around your home when you click on. It's entirely up to you. You can also set the screen brightness to auto-adjust based on how bright the room is, which is a neat feature. The Hub 2 also keeps the Hub Mini's infrared control features, allowing you to control TVs and other infrared devices around your home. However, the Hub 2 actually has a more powerful infrared chip, which is nice because this means that the infrared range is wider than the Hub Mini's range, so that's great. In terms of SwitchBot's Matter support, the Hub 2 connects to your Wi-Fi network, although it's worth noting that this only supports 2.4 GHz Wi-Fi, which is a shame. The Hub 2 can then offer Matter over Wi-Fi. And because the Hub 2 supports both Bluetooth and infrared, pretty much all of SwitchBot's products can connect to the Hub 2 and then effectively get Matter support too. And this then magically introduces them to a wide range of third-party platforms, including HomeKit. Yippee-ki-yay, Apple lovers! That's the idea, at least. In practice, getting individual products Matter certified still takes time. It's not just a case of copying and pasting random bits of code from the Matter GitHub project and then instantly having a product that is Matter compatible. As a result, at the time of filming, only the SwitchBot curtain and blinds supports Matter, something which was achieved via an over-the-air update in early March 2023. Many other SwitchBot's products will become Matter certified throughout 2023, though, although there is no fixed timeframe for this. SwitchBot's Matter support is still quite new, however I had no major issues with getting the SwitchBot curtain device installed or set up on the app. It all went fairly smoothly. SwitchBot's Matter support was still in beta support when I shot this, with Amazon support still pending, HomeKit support being fairly stable, and Google Home support being somewhere in between. However, after a frustrating 10 to 15 minutes with Google Home, I was finally able to get the Hub 2 integrated into my Google Home app, and I could then see the temperature data pull through. To do this, I ensured that I had all the latest app and firmware versions installed, and I then got the Matter QR code from the SwitchBot app. The Matter project likes to use easy identifiers like QR codes to set up devices easily in different apps. Once I had the QR code, I was then able to switch over to the Google Home app. At first, I couldn't add a Matter device because I apparently needed necessary Google Play services Matter modules, whatever they are, but Google's help pages went to a 404 page, which is a fail. But weirdly, after launching the SmartThings app, I could then force install these Matter modules and then finally add the SwitchBot Hub2 into the Google Home app. So this was all a bit buggy and clunky, but that's mainly down to initial teething issues. I expect these type of issues will get resolved soon enough, especially when smart devices and phone apps get all the necessary updates. One downside of the current Google Home integration was that I couldn't trigger Google Home routines based on the temperature or humidity settings, but this should be supported in the future, plus you can still configure this within the SwitchBot app. I then went back to test non-Matter support by linking it with Amazon Alexa, and I could then control it as you'd expect. Alexa routines worked fine as well. Now, you might point out the SwitchBot already supported Alexa, so this is no major surprise, but it's still good to see it work reliably after the Matter upgrade too. SwitchBot previously demonstrated Matter integration on a range of other platforms too, which I link to down in the description. Before I wrap up, I wanted to firstly say thank you to SwitchBot for sending me all of their awesome products to test out. SwitchBot has some really innovative products, so it's been fun to play around with them. The SwitchBot curtain was my favorite product. It was really cool. It's got two parts to it, which you basically clip onto your curtain rail, as you can see here up there. And then basically you switch over to the SwitchBot app and you calibrate it during the setup process. It finds out exactly where the open and the close positions are. And then once that's done, you know, you can automate things in the app. It's worth pointing out that the Hub2 doesn't support other companies' Matter products, and you will also still need the SwitchBot app. I say this because some people discuss Matter as though it's some sort of panacea that will allow you to mix and match different companies' Matter products and then only use a single app. But in practice, each company has their own slightly different Matter implementations, and so you can't just buy some random Matter certified product and then add it to the SwitchBot Hub2 via the SwitchBot app. That won't work. The era of having 20 different smart home apps is here to stay, at least until Matter support becomes much more widespread. Overall though, I really liked playing around with the Hub2 and also SwitchBot's first Matter certified product, the SwitchBot Curtains. It's particularly great to see some of SwitchBot's key products, like this one, become HomeKit friendly because it's been a long time coming. I will aim to dive into various companies' Matter support later this year when the dust settles, but for now, this all seems like a neat, future-proofed step by SwitchBot. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please click the thumbs up button. Please also click the subscribe button and ding the bell, which will notify you when I release new videos. Thank you.